Hi, this is Amber, Graphic Design How To, and today we're going to talk about Adobe Illustrator Workflow, 5 more tips for speed. The one I think you're really going to like is using the transform tool to warp objects, kind of like in Photoshop. It's pretty cool. Okay, let's get started. Okay, so the first thing we're going to learn about today is how to use the eyedropper tool to style text. And I have some styled text here. Let me zoom in on this. We've got some different fonts and colors, and we've got an icon. I'm going to go ahead and group that. A lot of times a client will want you to change this text to some other text. If you're getting that from a Microsoft Word document, it's going to come in Illustrator not in the best way. There are a couple ways you can do this, but I like to bring all of my text in at once like this and then style it using what's here already. Okay, so first I'm going to copy this and we'll just pull it up here. I'm going to hold Option to make a copy. And now we'll start replacing things. First we'll replace the icon. I'll grab this, put it here, and then Command-3 to hide. Then select this one and delete it. Then Option Command-3 to unhide. And now I'll use my eyedropper tool with the eye button and click the beard to get the same color. Next we'll grab Songs for Moms, maybe. Copy that, paste here, and then grab your eyedropper tool again. And you can keep doing that with every line of text that you come across. So we'll paste this here. It looks bad. We'll use the eyedropper tool, and now it looks good. And here's my final paragraph. And I'll go ahead and paste here. And then use my eyedropper tool. And that's it. We're ready to go. So that's an easy way to style text within Illustrator. I realize you can go back and forth from Illustrator to Word and you'll probably be okay, but that's a lot of extra clicks. So if you can get it done this way, the eyedropper tool is really handy. All right, tip number 2, using Command-D to create something like this. So first we need to get our shape, which is this petal shape. And to do that, I'm just going to draw a circle with the L tool. Okay, and hold Shift to make sure it's an actual circle. And now I want my anchor points. Right now they're on the sides and the top and bottom, and I want them on the angle. So let's hit E or R and hold Shift and drag it like this. With your A tool, select the bottom half, and you can see you've got 2 points selected there. Then hit Option Command J and do both. And now we can go to Pathfinder and divide this. The part I don't want is down here, so I'm going to Shift and highlight this and then just delete that piece. And now let's use our A tool to grab this and we'll pull it down like this. So that's a kind of quick way to get a petal shape. I'm going to copy this, paste in front, and then hit R. R is rotate, and if we click right down here on the bottom point, that will change the little target. So now hold Shift and then drag over. That's our first 2 petals, and now all we have to do is do Command C, F, D. Hold Command the entire time. So Command C, Command F, Command D, CFD, 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 CFD. Okay, so there you have it. That was an easy little petal, and if you like, you can add a little circle to the middle to have the center of the flower. All right, that is tip number 2. Now I want to show you this one I was talking about in the intro. This is using the warp and distort tool to quickly warp your text or any grouped object. We could do it with this or this little icon. It only makes sense to do it with several pieces because you could easily do it with a simple shape like this in other ways. So let's go ahead and make this text outlined. Shift Command O and now hit E. And this is our transform tool. Click on a corner and start dragging. And then hold command while you're dragging. You have to be while you're dragging, otherwise it won't work. Hold command. Now we're getting some crazy warping going on, which is pretty awesome. We could also warp it this way. Oops. You have to stretch first, which is just the problem I had. And then hold command. This is on a Mac. On a PC, it would probably be holding control, or I said hold command. So that is how you warp using the transform tool and the command or control key. Okay, number four. This one is super simple, small way to add anchor points in between every anchor point you already have. So that is option, path, add anchor points. And this is good. You can see now that we have a path, an anchor point between the two anchor points. This is good if you want to make ribbons and stuff. Okay, choose your A tool and draw a box around that middle point, and then you can hold shift and arrow in. I just clicked once with my arrow, so I'm going to click once with my arrow over here. And now we could go ahead and do some effects, warp, maybe arc, and 28% is good. And now we have a simple, fast ribbon. Okay, that was tip number four. I want to show you a way to make a super easy pie graph with the charts and graphs tool. So that's right down here, and you'll have to choose pie graph down here if it's not already up. Just draw a square and you can hold shift. I'm going to do 66 and 34 and then hit this check mark, and it will give you a simple pie graph with those coordinates. So I'm going to close this. Now it's a little hard to manipulate this, so I generally like to make a copy off to the left. This one is still has the live information inside it, but I want one that doesn't have it. So we'll go ahead and click on this and go to Object, Flatten Transparency, and just say OK. And now I'm going to click here, and hide those. Command 3. And delete the outlines, and then Option Command 3 to bring them back. And now we can color this whatever we want. I'll go ahead and color it what I've colored it over here. So with my Eye tool, I'll click there, and then Eye tool again. And then I think the cool way to do it these days is adding a circle to the middle. I'll eyedropper tool this circle. So we get that white, and then you can just add whatever text. These are great for infographics and any kind of data you're needing to put in a project. Okay, so this is Anne with Graphic Design How To. I hope this has been helpful for you today. If you like this video, click the like button. And if you want to see more videos like this, please subscribe. If you have any comments or questions, something isn't working for you, please leave those in the comments section below. Thanks, guys.